The 8th Conference of the Association of SAARC Speakers and Parliamentarians commenced in Colombo today. The conference was chaired by Speaker of Parliament Karu Jayasurya.
The 8th Conference of the Association of SAARC Speakers and Parliamentarians saw the participation of President Maithripala Sirisena, Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe, parliamentarians and speakers of all 7 SAARC countries.
We are proud to state that Sri Lanka has a proud record of upholding parliamentary democracy for continuous 70 years despite many obstacles, including 2 failed military coup attempts, 2 youth disturbances and a 30-year civil war that crippled the life of the whole country. We take pride to announce that today the Sri Lanka Parliament has been recognized as a role model for other countries by the Inter-Parliamentary Union, IPU. A code of conduct for the members of Parliament also has been drafted, almost finalized, with the intention of regulating the conduct of members of Parliament in their official capacity as representatives of the people. A new constitution which benefits all communities is also being drafted, having observed the views and aspirations of the people of Sri Lanka. With all these new initiatives, we firmly believe the parliament democracy will prosper in our country. Our consensual government believes working in agreement with all parties for the betterment of the country. And also after a long lapse, all the 8 SAARC countries are in Sri Lanka soil, and it's a great honor for our country for the presence of all 8 SAARC members at this moment.
We have to hold a consensus to move forward. It is like moving across a minefield. One false step and you will get blown up. That is what constitution making is. So how do we proceed on this? And firstly, we will look at the views that people will express, and we expect many of them to reflect the party positions. But the Constituent Assembly and the Steering Committee is also an opportunity to hold talks of the public eye. So we all agreed this country can't be divided. This country should be one. System of proportional representation and constituencies very much on the lines of the New Zealand system. Now we will know how the system works out, because in January we will be holding the elections to the local authorities. And that will give us experience of this election system. So it's a step by step, nothing has been concluded, and the next we will ask all the stakeholders outside Parliament to give us their views, consult with them, and then use this mechanism to form a consensus. But people are questioning us, when are you going to do it? So the parliamentarians have to realize that the time is limited. And in the course of early part of next year, we have to show that we are capable of taking the next steps.
A commemorative stamp was also issued to mark the 8th conference of the Association of SAARC Speakers and Parliamentarians in Sri Lanka.
The discussed committee report should be formulated with a multi-party involvement. The constitutional reform should not be formulated to advance personal agendas. However, it is important that the constitutional reform needs to consolidate democracy and assure the public of their freedom. Therefore, the government's efforts to present the interim report is being appreciated by us. And it's also very important that the interim report that will be taken up for discussion will be the same as the one that will be presented to Parliament. We do not want to see the recurrence of the Provincial Council Amendment Act scenario. The act should be discussed openly without tarnishing the image of the government, if the objective of the new act is the welfare of the public.